We are going to visit Taj Mahal. Is there anyone who knows what is the meaning of Taj Mahal?
Yeah, Mumtaz Mahal.
Yeah, that's the name of a queen.
Queen, yeah.
But literally, Taj means crown, and the Mahal means palace. Crown palace is the meaning of Taj Mahal. But we are not going to see the palace. Taj Mahal is a mausoleum. It's a tomb, a graveyard, which was built by Shah Jahan in the memory of his beautiful wife, Mumtaz Mahal. Shah Jahan was a Sunni Muslim. He was the fifth Mughal emperor of the Mughal dynasty. So according to Islam, Muslims can have four wives at the same time, but he had three number of wife, and Taj Mahal he built for his favorite number third wife, Mumtaz Mahal. And why she was the favorite wife of the king? She was beautiful. She was a legal advisor of the king. She was very loyal to the king, and the main reason from others to wife, he had no children, but from favorite wife who buried in Taj Mahal, he had 14 children. And she died giving the birth of number 14 child at the age of 39. So the king and queen, they lived together only for 19 years. And 14 kids. Unfortunately, out of 14, 8 were died in childhood, only 6 survived, in which 4 boys and 2 girls. Boys' names were Dara Shikoh, Shah Shuja, Murad, and Aurangzeb. I know it's difficult to remember all these names, but you can remember the last one, Aurangzeb. He was the youngest son of Shah Jahan, and according to history, he was very bad son, very cruel. You know why? The father of the king who built the Taj Mahal, Shah Jahan, he was arrested by his own son, by Aurangzeb. So why did he arrest his father? That story I will tell you later on. He had also two beautiful daughters, Roshanara and Jahanara. Taj Mahal, there are three best times to visit the Taj Mahal: sunrise, sunset, and moonlight. Suppose morning time, if you're going to visit the Taj Mahal, color will be pinkish. And kindly inform you, nowadays Taj Mahal is allowed to see at night also, but only 5 nights in a month during the full moon occasion. And if you want to see at night, one day before, you'll have to buy the tickets, because during the night, they allow only 400 visitors. So it closes at night. So the color will be milky white at night. There are three different entrances of Taj Mahal. Remember, we have entered from West Gate. West Gate, also known as local gate, domestic. Most of the Indian tourists enter through that gate. Then you can see the Eastern Gate over there, known as a VVIP gate. Whenever the Prime Minister or President come to visit Taj Mahal, they always enter through the East Gate. Then you can see behind me, South Gate, a very special gate. That time, workers who built the Taj Mahal, they used to live behind that gate. So South Gate, known as the Labour Colony Gate. So these are three different gates from where usually people buy the tickets of Taj Mahal. But nowadays, South Gate remain closed due to security reasons. You can take only exit, cannot enter. And you can see the main entrance of the Taj Mahal. This is just a gate of Taj Mahal itself, a beautiful structure. And the height of the gate from bottom to top, 105 feet, about 35 meters. And let me tell you, this is the second biggest door in Asia. And the height of the gate from bottom to top, 105 feet, 35 meters, imagine. And top of the gate, you can see the white small domes. Can you count how many number of domes over there? The white one?
11.
Yes, you're right. 11 domes on front side, 11 number of domes. You will see back side, 22 domes. This is a significant that Taj Mahal took to build 22 years. So each dome represents by 1 year. 1631 to 1653 was the construction period. And 20,000 workers worked here day and night for 22 years. And about 40 million rupees were spent for the building at that time. 400 back, 40 million rupees. If we try to calculate the value of the Taj Mahal, first of all, we'll have to calculate the value of the gold that time. 400 back, gold was like 10 rupees for 10 grams. Nowadays, is 40,000 rupees. 10 rupees and 40,000 rupees. This is how we can calculate the value of the Taj Mahal. And what is the beauty of the gate? Look at the color flower decoration, the floral designs above the arch, which does look like a painting, but there's no color. No paintings, all are real stones inlaid in a marble. This is a work also known as mosaic work. In India, we call it inlay work, or Hindi, we call it meenakari or pachekari. 24 different type of stones they used there to decorate the whole Taj Mahal. And stones we classify in two categories, precious stones or semi-precious stones. Precious were emerald, rubies, diamond, and sapphire. Unfortunately, there's no any more, because most of the precious stone was stolen by East India Company, by the British. You can see only semi-precious stones. Light green stone is jade from China. Dark green is malachi from South Africa, Zambia. Black onyx from Belgium. Blue lapis lazuli from Afghanistan. Red coral from Egypt. Sky blue turquoise from Turkey. Blue lapis lazuli from Afghanistan. Orange cornelian from Yemen. Tiger eyes from Sri Lanka. So that time, 400 back, no transportation. So the river is flowing behind the Taj Mahal. That's Yamuna, the second sacred river after Ganges. So by river, camels, horses, and elephants are used to bring this stone. That is why it took to build so long, 22 years. And another beauty of the gate, you can see the black writing three sides of the gate. Quran, the holy book of Islamic people, written in Arabic language. If you want to read, it's right to left. One of the words known as Surah Al-Fajr, a door to the heaven is written on a gate. And what is the beauty? Even the calligraphy, the writing, is not painting. That's a stone onyx inlet in a marble. And look at the letters from bottom to top carefully. Size of the letters appears like the same size, but the letters are written in V shape. The bottom fonts are smaller and top is bigger. So as the letters going up, the font size is getting bigger. As going up is getting bigger, so people can read for the perceptive view. That's an illusion, optical illusion, and the art of calligraphy done by best calligrapher ever, Amanatka Shirazi from Iran, from Persia. Now look at the rooms around you. These all are total 200 and number of rooms. That time 400s back, there were no hotels, there were no guest houses, so people like us used to come stay in those rooms. But nowadays rooms are empty, nothing to see. But that time rooms were beautifully decorated for their privacy. There were curtains, there were carpets, there were beautiful chandelier. But again, most of the valuable things were stolen by East India Company. So I will explain you point to point. If you have any questions regarding history, you can ask me anytime. And let's please you be together in a group, because when we go in Taj Mahal, I have the tickets. Without the ticket, they won't let you enter in Taj Mahal. You have to show this ticket, only then you can enter in white building. So please be together in a group. And it's busy there today, so be aware of your belongings. Weekends are always busy, so keep your belongings. As per rule of government, no constructions, no buildings allowed behind the Taj Mahal. As you can see, Taj Mahal is made of marble. This is made of world best quality marble. And the marble came from Makrana, the place of Rajasthan, 285 kilometers far from Agra, were carried by 1,000 elephants.
Really?
Even though Taj Mahal is not made of solid marble, solid stone cannot stay for longer, so the internal structure is made of bricks. And the foundation, the building foundation is very deep. Instead of stone or concrete, that foundation is made of wood, wooden foundation. That wood known as a black wood or ebony wood. So in case of earthquake, it will absorb the shock. It does work like a suspension. And they build a structure such as that way. Look at the minaret. There are four pillars on the four corners. Look at them carefully. Minarets will fall down outside, not on a building. Shah Jahan, who built the Taj Mahal, it says that in history, he just ruled 30 years, but that was the golden period of the Mughal dynasty. In terms of architecture style, he was famous with the two beautiful things. First is Taj Mahal we are going to see. Second was a peacock throne. Have you heard about it? A throne of justice. The place where he used to sit and deliver the justice. Peacock throne was as valuable as Taj Mahal. But the throne was taken by a Persian invader, Nader Shah. So nowadays you will see in a museum of Tehran in Iran. Height of the building from bottom to top, 81 meters, about 243 feet. Taj Mahal is a symmetrical building. Symmetry is a basic element of Islamic architecture style. As you can see from front side, if you go right inside, back side or left side, from all four sides, it looks same. Except the Quranic verses, same writing but different words. Surah Al-Yasin, the heart of Quran, is written on Taj Mahal. So except the words, entire building is symmetrical. Taj Mahal, in India, it doesn't belong to any religion. It belongs to the people who believes in love. Because Taj Mahal, in India, we consider it as a symbol of love. And Taj Mahal is an Indo and Islamic architecture style monument. It's just not only Islamic. Shah Jahan was a Muslim, but this is Indo and Islamic. Look at the dome of the Taj Mahal, the main one, bigger one. Just look at the shape, a shape of onion. This is again sign of the Islamic architecture style. Islamic dome, always you will find an onion shape. But what is the uniqueness? They are double dome structure. From here you can see the outer dome. When you go inside the Taj Mahal, you will see inner dome. And there is nothing between two domes. To minimize the weight of outer dome, there's another dome inside. Is there anyone who knows about the biggest double dome structure of this world? Vatican City. St. Peter's Church has got biggest double dome. And the oldest double dome you will see in Florence, that's Duomo. So this is very much influenced by Italian dome. Above the dome you can see inverted lotus like umbrella. Lotus flower nowadays is a national flower of India. But according to Hindu religion, Hindu mythology. Do you know about Hindu religion? We believe in reincarnation. So there's a life after that. So there are three supreme powers and 85,000 god and goddess. That's Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. This is a definition of the god. Generator, operator and destroyer. So Brahma. Lotus flower was a vehicle of Brahma. Therefore, lotus flower is a great symbol in Hindu religion. You can see on top. And very top you can see half moon. Symbol of Islam that you can see in the flag of Pakistan or flag of Turkey. So this is Indo and Islamic mixed architecture style. Look at the gardens here. The beautiful pattern. We call it Charbagh. Four gardens pattern. Charbagh pattern. Four gardens pattern is very familiar in Mughal architecture style. Wherever you go, always you will find Charbagh pattern. So it became a signature mark of the Mughal architecture style. Have you heard about the Kohinoor diamond? the biggest diamond of this world.
Yeah,
now the diamond
the
you will
queen.
See in the Queen of England, you will see London, which was stolen by British from India. How expensive, how big is Kohinoor diamond? If we believe the autobiography of Babur, the founder of Mughal dynasty, he wrote his autobiography called Babur Nama. According to that book, whole world can have food three times. That is the value of Kohinoor diamond. And also said that diamond is bad luck for a man and good luck for a woman. Shahjahan, when he became a king, he shifted his capital because man has to pay all the time. So Shahjahan, when he became a king, he shifted his capital from Agra to Delhi. Nowadays it's called Old Delhi, but that time city was known as Shahjahanabad. Bad means city, so the red fort in Delhi built by Shahjahan, same guy who built the Taj Mahal. Look at the dome again. Above the dome you can see the pinnacle metal part. Let me tell you, nowadays that part is made of bronze, but that time it was gold. But in 1810 that gold was replaced by Captain Joseph Taylor by the British. Do you have any idea how big, how tall is the metal part?
Yeah.
10 meters, 3 stories, 30.6 feet. It doesn't look that big, but that part is actually 10 meters. Imagine that was gold at that time, which was replaced by Captain Joseph Taylor in 1810. So many things were stolen by them from India. In the center there, you can see fountains. Fountains are still running, functioning, but nowadays the fountains runs by electric. For 400 back, that time no electricity. So how the fountain used to in old days? You can see the outer wall. Behind the wall, there were two water tanks on very high, 80 to 150 feet. Manually, they used to fill the water, and water used to run by pressure. That's called gravity. Mm. By the gravitational force, fountain used to run at that time. So now we will go inside the Taj Mahal. Once we reach over there, you have to wear the covers over the shoe. And photography is not allowed inside the mausoleum. Okay. We'll go closer, and I will explain you again when we get closer.
Again, take a time.